That was the Prime Minister down the barrel making his pitch for re-election, declaring the election will take place on May 21st and beginning the campaign for the Prime Ministership for the 48th, it will be, Parliament of Australia. Let's bring in Chris Uhlmann, our political editor. Chris, he dialed the oi, oi, oi factor up to about 10 at the start, saying he loves the country and loves Australia. Here we go.
Here we go, Charles. And he tried to frame this debate. And what did he say? This election is not about me, it's about you. Don't forget the major attack line against the government is that Scott Morrison can't be trusted. He's now saying this election is all about you. So that is one of the main points to take away from this. He is trying to shift the focus and he's trying to move it onto his team. His team he mentioned several times. Remember last time the presidential campaign was all about him. This time he's talking about a team with a plan and a team with a record, which he tried to reclaim for the government, saying, look, on any measure, what we did in the pandemic, actually the recovery is coming out reasonably well. And a contrast, it's between us, who you know, warts and all, and a Labor Party that you do not know. And what do we know? Then he went through the entire list of things that we know about this government and the Labor Party. Well, we have a strong economy against, well, a Labor Party that would weaken it. We have a responsible management of the economy against the chaotic management of comes from Labor. Unemployment would always be lower, he says, under a coalition. We talk about prices of electricity, interest rates going up. So on all these possible futures that he's talking about, he's saying a tried and trusted, not perfect government up against a risk in Labor and Anthony Albanese.
I'm intrigued by the message. He says, I'm optimistic about our future. This comes on the same day that the Defence Minister said that he believes there will be a conflict in our region in the coming years. How does that work?
Well, yet more reason to vote for the coalition, isn't it, Charles? And that's precisely the groundwork they're trying to lay, which is these are dangerous times. And in fact, the Prime Minister's right about that. Anthony Albanese also knows that. Whoever becomes Prime Minister after this election will face the most uncertain times that any Prime Minister has faced since the Second World War. And that's not about COVID-19. That's about the clash of ideas and ideologies between autocracies and democracies. We're seeing that played out in Russia. We're entering a new Cold War. We need to work out how we deal with a rising China, which is going to test us and test any future Prime Minister. So part of the pitch of the government is if you want to feel safe, if you want to feel secure, then Scott Morrison is someone who can deal with that, or you can risk Anthony Albanese. Now, these, of course, this is the way that the government wants to frame this, is precisely the opposite of the way that the Labor Party will try and frame it. They'll say tired, old, out of puff, now out of time, kick them out.
The Prime Minister also committed to three more years. That would take him into the top seven when it comes to long-serving Prime Ministers. Laurie Oakes said last time that they'd build a statue to him if he won the election. I think the statue would have to get to gargantuan sizes if he wins again. But this is about voters, and the cost of living was at the centre of Labor's attack. It was mentioned today. How pivotal will that be?
Oh, absolutely pivotal. And what we've seen is there are only really three elements to the government's budget when you boil it down. It was that they were cutting petrol excise in half, 22 cents a litre. They've already claimed credit for oil prices falling essentially by saying prices are already lower. We actually won't see that excise cut come through for a couple of weeks or so until they empty their tanks, that's the petrol stations, and fill them up with the excise halved version of petrol. Then there was a direct handout to people who are on fixed payments like pensioners, disability pensioners. And then, of course, there was the extension of a tax claim that you can make at the end of the financial year, all three of which are cost of living measures. So that what they wanted there was for some immediate relief to give people the impression that the government was trying to do something about this. The Labor Party, of course, is promising even more. It'll take what the government does and also offer you help with childcare, help with healthcare. So yes, kitchen table economics. Again, Charles, you will remember this. This was the Rudd campaign of 2007, not national economics, not big picture economics. It was kitchen table economics. What's happening in your household?
Yeah, your bottom line becomes the bottom line. Chris, really appreciate your time this morning. Look forward to the next 41 days and beyond as Australia goes to the polls. There you have it. May 21st, Australia decides. Really important to note, you can make sure your details are up to date so you can have your say. Jump on the AEC website. It is AEC. You can see there, .gov.au. I am Charles Crouch. This has been Nine News. Thank you for your company. We'll have full wraps, details and Anthony Albanese's response in Nine News at 6 o'clock tonight.